20, Friday. We are in the second week of Easter. I welcome you all for this Eucharistic celebration. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. We are in the Easter season. Today's liturgy calls us to remember that Jesus is with us as Emmanuel, He lives with us. In today's gospel passage, Jesus performs the miracle of multiplication of loaves, 5 loaves and 2 fishes. We are indeed happy, and we need to be sure that Jesus is with us, especially in times of difficulties. He is assuring His presence and His miracle. With the same assurance and hope, let us try to partake in this Holy Eucharistic celebration in a worthy manner. Let us recall to our mind all our sins and failures, ask God's pardon and mercy. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, and in what I have done, and in what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Opposing to God. So they took his advice And when they had called in the apostles, they beat them and charged them not to speak in the name of Jesus, and let them go. Then the apostles left the presence of the council, rejoicing that they were counted worthy to suffer dishonor for the name. And every day in the temple and at home, they did not cease teaching and preaching Jesus as the Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, your response. There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my help. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Before whom shall I shrink? Your response.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, for this I long, to live in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, to savor the sweetness of the Lord, to behold His temple. Your response.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
I am sure I shall see the Lord's goodness in the land of the living. Hope in Him, hold firm and take heart. Hope in the Lord. Your response.
There is one thing I ask of the Lord, to live in the house of the Lord.
Gospel acclamation.
Now, the Passover, the feast of the Jews, was at hand. Lifting up his eyes then, and seeing that a multitude was coming to him, Jesus said to Philip, "How are we to buy bread so that these people may eat?" This he said to test him, and for he himself knew what he would do. Philip answered him, 200 denarii would not buy enough bread for each of them to get a little." One of the disciples, Andrew, Simon Peter's brother, said to him, "There is a lad here who has 5 barley loaves and 2 fish. But what are they among so many?" Jesus said, "Make the people sit down." Now there was much grass in the place, so the men sat down, in number about 55,000. Jesus then took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed them to those who were seated, and also the fish, as much as they wanted. And when they had eaten their fill, he told his disciples, "Gather up the fragments left over, that nothing may be lost." So they gathered them up and filled 12 baskets with fragments from the 5 barley loaves left by those who had eaten. When the people saw the sign which he had done, they said, "This is indeed the prophet who is to come into the world." Perceiving then that they were about to come and take him to by force to make him the king, Jesus withdrew again to the hills by himself. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My dear brothers and sisters in Jesus Christ, we are familiar with the Gospel passage of Last Supper. Three Gospels out of four narrate this episode. One of the surprising things is the apostles and the first Christian community in the early church, they were very much fond of the Gospel that we read today. Along with the passage of Last Supper, they were very much interested and loved to listen to the episode of multiplication of loaves and fish. In the Gospel, at least six times this episode is narrated. We know four Gospels, for six times they are narrating this episode. What is the speciality in it? Let us see which are those episodes. Gospel of Luke, chapter 9, verses from 10 to 17. Gospel of Matthew, chapter 14, verses from 13 to 21. Gospel of Matthew, chapter 15, verses 32 to 39. And Mark, chapter 6, 30 to 44. Again, Gospel of Mark, chapter 8, verses 1 to 9. And lastly, in today's Gospel passage, as we read, Gospel of John, verses from 1 to 15. In all these six episodes, Matthew and Mark, for two times, they mention this miracle episode. My dear friends in Jesus Christ, the early church, they love to read and reflect on this Gospel passage again and again, because this passage of multiplication of loaves and fish prefigured the liturgy of Eucharist to the early Christian community. There are some possible signs that we can see in today's Gospel passage. Let us see at least 5 points that is given in today's Gospel passage. First, Jesus, after breaking the word of God, he breaks the bread. That is to say, after the liturgy of word of God, Jesus prefigures the liturgy of Eucharist. These are early Christian community, they are fond of this Gospel because it is very near to the Eucharistic celebration. Second point is, the symbolical sign that we see is, Jesus instructs the big crowd to be distributed in the number of 50 each. The number 50 is very important in the Gospel and the Bible. The number 50, it comes in the New Testament and other episodes. After the resurrection of Jesus, on the 50th day, on the Pentecost day, the coming of the Holy Spirit we celebrate in the church. The number 50 is important. So this also prefigures that Jesus divided the Christian community in a possible small Christian community to celebrate the word of God, to celebrate the Eucharist in a better way. So he prefigured the creation of different small Christian community. The third point is number 7. There are 7 food items given in today's Gospel passage. A poor lad, a boy, he had 5 loaves and 2 fishes. He had 7 food items. So with these 7 food items, Jesus performed this miracle. So number 7 is very important in the Bible. God created the world in 7 days. And on the 7th day, God called the human being to rest and to remember the Lord. And because of this, we celebrate the special Eucharistic celebration on the seventh day, on the Sabbath day. We are very familiar with the word bread. Jesus himself says, "I am the bread of life, came down from heaven, and those who receive this bread will receive eternal life." But the surprising thing is, why this early Christian community are fond of this fish? This fish symbolized the early Christian community. Today we have the crucifix, Jesus hanging on the cross, as a symbol of Christian community. But in the early Christian community, the fish was the symbol of the early Christian community. Fourth point is Jesus pronouncing the Eucharistic prayer. Jesus taking the loaf, gave thanks, and he distributed it to the crowd. And again, he did the same with the fish. So this also prefigures that Jesus gave the Eucharistic prayer to the church. And the last point is the remaining fragments were about 12 baskets. The number 12 is also very important, that it symbolizes the 12 apostles. Jesus called the 12 apostles to carry out this Eucharistic celebration and celebration of the Word of God throughout the church, wherever the Christian community is present. So here Jesus prefigures the spread of the Word of God and the celebration of the Holy Eucharistic celebration. My dear friends in Jesus Christ, in all these gospel narrations about this multiplication of loaves and fish, the common point that we can reflect is that Jesus is present in amidst us, especially in times of our difficulties. He is present in times of our sickness, in times of our need. When we call upon Jesus, he knows what he has to do, and he will be with us. Not only that, he will perform miracle. In today's first reading, we read how apostles were unlawfully attacked by the Jews, and the head of the Sanhedrin, Gamaliel, he delivers them lawfully, and leaves them free. That's how Jesus comes to our rescue in times of our difficulties, and he is with us. That is the assurance that the Lord is giving us in today's liturgy. May God continue to bless us. Let us be sure of God's presence, and let us hope that he is with us, he is Emmanuel, and he is living among us.
But attain the gifts that are eternal.
through Christ our Lord. Even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
He took bread and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Together with Francis of Pope and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servants,
especially the people who have died because of coronavirus. You have taken them from this world to yourself. Grant that they who were united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with them in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. Now who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with St. Joseph, our spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the service command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we will be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant the peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my roof, but only say a word, and my soul shall be healed. Lord, as the centurion prayed, Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. We too, with total surrender, pray to you, Lord Jesus. Though we are unworthy to receive you into our hearts, without considering our limitations, Lord, by your love and blessings, help us to remain faithful to you. Grant us the grace to live as your children, bearing witness to your gospel every day. Help us to live a life according to the will of God, the Father. Come and help us to do your good works. Free us from all danger and protect us from every mishappenings. Fill us with your love and faith. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Let us pray. Keep safe, O Lord, we pray, those whom you have saved by your kindness, that remember, by the passion of your Son, they may rejoice in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit,
one God forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
The Almighty God bless you, the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is celebrated. Go in the peace of Christ.